Con Cox Internet y Home Life, sabes cuándo llega tu pizza. Ver cámaras.
¡Pizza!
Ve tus cámaras Home Life en tu TV con el control por voz de Contour.
Funciones requieren suscripción a Cox Internet y Contour TV. Servicios provistos por entidades licenciadas de Cox. Cox.com/licencias.
I'm Doc Rivers, and I'm proud to present a new podcast documentary series called It Was Said Sports, where I guide you through six of the most impactful and timeless speeches in sports history. Listen and follow It Was Said Sports, a documentary podcast presentation of Shining City Audio, a C-13 Originals, and John Meacham Studio. Available now on Odyssey and wherever you listen to your podcasts.
Hello, everybody. As Adam said, it's a beautiful Wednesday afternoon. Again, nobody touts September weather more than me. We are here until 3.
Pardon me? Excuse me? What'd you just say?
I've always been a big backer of September.
You fraud.
Dark.
You fraud.
That's why it was dark at 7:30 last night, this phony month. You know, my month of July, it's sunny until 9:45. I guess if you like darkness, hello darkness, my old friend. September is your month. And it feels like 40 out there. DeRussia. At 12:35, Dr. Michael Ostrom, 105, Playing Politics, 135, Jeff Anderson on the litigation against the GOP operative child sex grooming, all coming up. Indulge me, but then I also want you to participate the emotions of today. I'm going to start with myself. I believe I have four sons. I have three biological sons, and then Michael came into my life about 7 years ago. Michael is every bit my son as those boys are, and my boys know that. I love Michael. He is an amazing part of my life, so I tell everybody I have four kids. Quentin is 20. Quentin, third child with Kathleen. We were done. Life was pretty good in 2000. Our marriage was great. Professionally, things were good. I was switching over to TV to work with Jim Pete. I had agreed to become the Arizona Cardinals play-by-play announcer. And I was on a trip to Scotland, shockingly, to play golf. When I received the most surprising, one of the greatest phone calls of my life, when I called Kathleen and she told me, she was pregnant. We had decided we were done. We were using birth control. Guess what? Thankfully, and I could say that in an infinity amount of times, the birth control did not work because Quentin came into our life. I just had a bad feeling for some reason during the pregnancy that something health-wise wasn't right. And eventually I told Kathleen, and that probably was a mistake. But I was worried. And Quentin was born. I broadcast a game. I stopped the Arizona Cardinals idea because I was going to have another child, and the Sean Grandin's silly litigation ended up switching the Wolves situation around, but I also switched some things to the fan too, knowing another child was coming, moved away from afternoon drive. Q's born. I had flown back from a Wolves trip, and he looked different to me than my other boys, and guess what? Last time I checked, I'm not a doctor, so maybe I'm wrong. And I remember I was in town, was flying back to L.A. just quickly to call one Wolves game, and Kathleen called me, and I'm on the flight. Doors are about to shut, and she's emotional, as she should have been, saying, Quentin has spina bifida. And I'm like, what does he have? I knew it. She's like, they're going to do tests. I'm like, the doors are shutting. Should I get off the plane? No. And for 3.5 hours, you know, at that point, you couldn't check anything on your phone. In April of 2001, land, no, he doesn't have spina bifida, but it just started the odyssey for Q. He wouldn't breastfeed. He would not bottle feed. We went to our regular pediatrician 3 times in 10 days because our son was just crying constantly. And finally, I went to my friend, Dr. Paul Wernick, who is a pediatrician and is one of the greatest people I've ever met in my life. And he took me to his former pediatric office, because Paul had stepped away and was involved in other work. And Quinton, for the first time, I don't know, maybe this is 11, 12 days into his life, finally we found the right nipple for him to take in food, nutrition. And we thought, well, maybe we discover something here. And then he projectile vomited about 4 feet away against the wall, and Dr. Cavender said, you need to go to the hospital right now. And it just started the odyssey again, because we would have heart concerns. He would stop breathing one time. He would spend weeks and weeks and really totally months in the hospital with health issues. We couldn't find out what his diagnosis was. We held him back. He was so much smaller. He wasn't communicating. We thought he might be on the autistic spectrum, but we weren't certain. We were sending his information, and we were traveling across the country, meeting with doctors. And finally, a man who's still my doctor, Dr. Sheldon Burns, just stopped me one time and said, you need to stop. He just has Quinton Hartman syndrome, and it's just too tough on him going all over the place. And as usual, Sheldon was right. And eventually affirmed that Q was on the autistic spectrum and that he was going to have incredibly just daily challenging issues with reflux and going to the bathroom. And, you know, Q's never going to spend a day alone on his own. Just doesn't have that ability. And would have major leg surgery in November of 2016 and wouldn't walk for 6 months. A couple months into that, had a grand mal seizure. Now seizures are a part of his life. And every single damn day, and I mean every single day, no matter how much pain he's in, no matter how much reflux he's battled or bathroom issues or he's had a seizure or he's so tired from it, he wakes up with a smile on his face. And he lights up a room. And I love my three other boys every bit as much. And I'm so lucky to have Hunter Griffin and Mike in my life. But that kid of mine is my hero. And I've been around sports and accomplished individuals my entire life because of my father. And then the last 31 years doing this myself. Actually, going back to 88 starting. I will never have anybody who approaches hero status like Quinton does for me. And today, for the last time, he starts his final year of school. He is in a transition program for kids with intellectual delays, and he gets to go back to school. And I don't know how long he's going to get back to school. He's got his mask on. That's following the policy of the school because he gets sick. He's immune compromised. And when Kathleen, my ex-wife, and I, who now we get along just fantastically, I couldn't ask for a better partner in raising our kids, even though we're divorced, just sitting there. And she's crying, and I'm acting like the emotions aren't getting to me, but I was lying. So for me to see my boy and everything he's overcome, to get on that bus, it was just, simply put, one of the greatest moments of my life to see everything that Quinton has overcome. And I know it's only a start. But I also know, I know I've got that phone in front of me in case something happens. And also know he is elated to be back with his friends and learning things and just the enjoyment. And everybody's got their something. That's why we play Nika Costa on this show. Everybody's got their something. Quinton's something is overcoming so much and doing it with a smile. And if you're around my son and he doesn't make you happy, it's time for you to look in your soul. Because that's the kind of kid he really is. And it's taught me so much about my failures and what I get mad at, what's not worth to get mad at, and just so much of this for the show, and I love doing this. The Knucklehead News guy is one of my two or three closest friends on the planet. Dan is an absolute rock for me. We give strong opinions here. This is radio. Right. And I mean it. I'm not lying about what we do, but there's a quote unquote show business part of this. we may be very, very, very strong in our opinions on certain topics, but trust me, off air, we're not taking ourselves too serious. People who do are insufferable. We all need reminders of what's amazing in our life. And again, I have three other boys who mean the world to me, and I love them every bit as much. But just seeing everything Quentin has overcome and to see today was just an amazing moment that I'm just not going to forget. So I want to hear what today means to you when you think about challenges either you have faced, your family's faced, or school. Maybe your memories of your first day of school. What you saw today with your daughter, with your son, with the nephew, the pictures you saw, and what today might mean. I would love for your candor and your openness. I'm drawn to that. That's why I love doing it with Adam and Dan. They're willing to share. That's why I'm drawn to other shows when they're open and honest. And I get that people may not agree with their open and honest approach, but we're trying. So I would love for you to share something you've overcome, something you've overcome in your family, somebody close to you that does this, and the admiration just pours out of you because what you see. And also maybe what today means with almost everybody back in school today. 651-461-9226. 651-461-9226. Love some calls in this. If texts work better, that's fine. Again, 651-461-9226. We're going to play tunes from the 70s. I was reminded, looking in the closet that exists as my office, picked this up years and years ago, tunes from the 1970s. The Guess Who, American Woman, Adam Carter.
Can I guess?
Saw the Guess
why
Who
we're playing
70s? One time,
yeah,
at the Caboose nice. In the 1980s on a gorgeous night. Then saw him in Arizona, and Burton Cummings wasn't there, and some guy wearing a flowered shirt with a collar up was instead of Burton Cummings.
No, you want
one of the
Burton.
Most disgusting yeah. nights of my life.
Jeez.
Oh, horrifying.
Are we playing 70s music to honor the time when you peaked?
When did I peak? Hasn't happened yet. We're still waiting. 56 years. Has not happened. Okay. Today for you, or witnessing other people, Adam, overcoming remarkable challenges. What do you got?
I'd like to honor my two daughters for overcoming the challenges of having me as a father. How about that?
Yes.
In seriousness.
We know the feeling.
I haven't been shy about, my first marriage failed, and it had a lot to do with me. Because that failed, I also, in that aspect, part of my life, failed as a father. But that being said, my kids have, under circumstance, I've always tried to put them first, but it hasn't been an easy last 3 years. But they have persevered, and I cannot tell you, and I cannot tell you how incredibly proud of my daughters I am, because they are such good kids, almost to a fault, and they have persevered through, trouble at home that we tried not to have them affected by, but it's impossible to not be affected by that. But also just life changes for me, and now with my marriage to Jennifer and her two kids, who are now my stepchildren, who I love as well, my daughter's being put in that position of, okay, now you're a stepbrother and a stepsister. But I cannot tell you, they haven't missed a beat in school. They haven't missed a beat intellectually, socially. And they are absolute joys in my life. And my oldest is starting her first day as a freshman in high school. I can't believe that. And they make me a better person, that's for sure. Not only just being witnessing them and seeing the love they give me, but also just forcing me to be a better person in the decisions I make as professionally and personally. So, yeah, I they are absolute joys in my life, and I could not be any happier with my two girls.
Beautifully stated. Dan?
My hero has always been my younger brother, to be honest with you. And this is one of those things that I joke about that I'm glad he doesn't listen to the show because I'll never admit this to him. But the truth of the matter is we're so opposite in so many ways, and where I take a safe path in so many different things, he takes the road less traveled, and that has led to a bunch of really good stuff in his life, and that has led to a bunch of very challenging things in his life. But when I see him with his family, he's got a son who started his senior year of high school this year, and then he's got three, one in second grade, one starting kindergarten, and one that's starting daycare for the first time, and they all had the signs out today, and I saw that, you know, my sister-in-law sent me those pictures. But between that and all the responsibilities he takes on with his job, with his coaching, as a man of his faith, it just never ceases to amaze me how much of life he embraces and can handle in a way that I can't. You know, I mean, we've talked plenty of times about my introversion and my need to not be around people a whole lot. And when I see what he's able to accomplish, having lived on this earth less time than I have versus what I've done, you know, it could inspire some form of jealousy or envy, but it doesn't. It, for me, because I know where my limits are and I know that, you know, I'm trying to do the best that I can, but it still never ceases to amaze me what he's able to take on and handle. And when he makes mistakes, the way that he's able to respond to those mistakes, I think, has just been an incredible blessing for me to see and be a part of and be a support system for and to learn from. So he's always been my hero.
That's just fantastic. Let's go to a call here. A bunch of texts coming in also. Marie is in Richfield, 651-461-9226. Go ahead, Marie. You're on CCO.
Yeah, I thanks for having me on, letting me share my story. I have four children. My husband and I have four children, and they all are great kids. My youngest daughter was adopted when she was 17 months by us. She was adopted out of an orphanage in China. She wouldn't put her feet down on the ground, so she was not walking. She had double cleft lip and palate. She wasn't hearing, and she wasn't making any noises. She made no noises at all. This weekend, we dropped her off at the University of Minnesota, and she entered the School of Nursing at the University of Minnesota. And if any, people could correct me, but that's a 1% of the kids who apply to the School of Nursing get in. And not only did she overcome her 2 years of high school during COVID, which any kid who survived that is a hero, but I often tell her she's my hero.
That's awesome. That is absolutely awesome. Thanks for calling. Call in again, okay? Beautiful. Yeah. Let's see. Let's get to some of the texts here. Great subject. Oh, Lord, Chad, I'm in tears. That was so heartfelt and beautiful. Let me talk about what's important to you. And also... love to Adam and Dan, of course, and saying kind things about Quentin. Thanks for sharing about Q. My sister, now passed, had Rubenstein-Taibbi syndrome. I hope I'm getting that right. I really do. Which wasn't defined when she was born in 1962. The doctors knew there was something different. Told our parents, you just take her home and love her. She taught us more about humanity, compassion, grit, and resilience, love, and the goodness of God than anyone else could have. So grateful for her life. More here. 3 years ago this month, I nearly died after having major gastrointestinal surgery to remove cancerous tumors from my abdomen. My son was in third grade. Enter COVID. Basically, hasn't been a normal year since second grade. He spent the last year and a half doing distance learning to keep me safe. Tumors removed, but I still received treatment to keep the cancer asleep. Today at age 12 and fully vaccinated, he started middle school. My husband and I cried as we dropped him off, feeling so grateful for everything we've been through. Hoping all the kiddos have a safe year. Let's all hope for that. Wish everybody only the best. Let's talk to our friend Jason DeRusha in moments here on CCO.
I'm Erin Ryan, political commentator, comedy writer, and host of Crooked Media's Hysteria.
And I'm co-host Alyssa Mastromonaco, former White House Deputy Chief of Staff for President Obama.
Each week on Hysteria, we are joined by a team of hilariously opinionated ladies to discuss the headlines from the serious to the absurd.
We cover everything from reproductive rights to rom-coms and break down the political news of the week and cultural stories that affect women's lives.
New episodes of Hysteria drop every Thursday. Listen on Odyssey, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, I'm Peter Bukowski, host of the Locked On Today podcast. Trying to stay on top of every big story in sports is a full-time job. I know, because it is my full-time job. But it's not yours. That's why we have a network of local experts ready to give you the inside scoop on everything you truly need to know in the sports world. And we do it every day to make sure you're always caught up on the latest and greatest in sports. Listen to the Locked On Today podcast every day on the Odyssey app or wherever you get podcasts.
You want to know what Wagertainment is? It's the picks, the analysis, the information mixed with the laughter and the entertainment, smart sports betting content that'll put a smile on your face.
The BetQL Network, streaming live each day and helping you bet smarter.
If you're a sports fan, you know why you should listen. It's sports betting content without the BS. No hot takes, no nonsense.
The BetQL Network, streaming live right now on Odyssey.
Sports, bets, and entertainment.